You're saying both,
okay.
Yeah.
Okay, I can
so
do
say
that.
Welcome back, that was a delicious dinner. They say we're going to continue, and then I say that, and you say, oh god, we're going to be talking for ages.
Wait, so then I say that as well?
No, part. Don't say that.
Okay, you just said whole
You
intro.
Just say that and that, and then I say that. We're getting rid of that.
Oh, okay.
Because it's like,
yeah. It's not first up.
Okay, we got this. Woo.
Do we have to like turn it on or something?
I don't know how to stand. I'm just going to stand. Look at those flowers, they're so cute.
I'm literally actually freezing.
I'm not that cold anymore, but I'm kind of nervous.
Wait, where's my goosebumps? Oh, but like, I get, sweat. When I, after I eat, I literally get like cold. I don't know what
oh,
it is.
Oh, really?
It's like this thing that my mum gave me.
Oh,
so
that's
after,
weird.
I know, after we
well,
eat.
Well, I was having, like, getting cold. Cramps, so I'm so glad that we ate, because now it's like, better. Stress level is higher. We're waiting. Look at those, them social distancing.
I know, look at them go. I'm pretty sure, like,
are we live? Are we live?
Check.
Testing. 1, 2, 3. They're like matching. That's so cute.
Oh, we're good to go.
Oh, okay.
Welcome. Is it going? Welcome back. Okay. That was a delicious dinner, and I hope you enjoyed it as much as we did. Emily and I are going to continue as your MCs for the evening, and straight up, we want to present you with our review of 2020.
So as you all know, this year we've been faced with many challenges due to COVID, and even though our Netball dinner is a little different this year, we think that we should still be very grateful that we've been able to gather tonight to celebrate what a great year we've had, and how lucky we are to be holding it in the brand new Performing Arts Centre here at school.
At the start of 2020, we had the privilege of welcoming into our family 28 new teammates, and all the Year 10 girls couldn't wait to meet our new Year 7 buddies. We can all remember our first day back in Year 7, which doesn't seem that long ago, and it reminds us how quickly our time in the academy passes. This year, the Grade 7s have brought so much enthusiasm to the academy. They have been such amazing buddies this year. We feel so lucky to have gotten such a brilliant bunch of girls. You guys have come to early morning trainings, carnivals, and other events, and have become part of the Netball Academy family. We appreciate the effort you guys have put into this year, especially as COVID impacted you guys pretty hard. You have shown us on several occasions that you are dedicated, enthusiastic, and great team members. This was especially evident at the afternoon tea held earlier this year, where you guys got involved and really made the day special. We want to thank you for joining our family, and please don't forget to make the most of every opportunity ahead, as before you know it, you'll be standing up here hosting the final dinner when you're in Year 10. Who could have predicted COVID impacting our year so much? During quarantine, many of us were bored of doing the same thing every day. Through quarantine, the Netball Academy helped us stay connected and sane through fun and engaging activities. This is all credit to Mrs. Stickney and Mrs. Southwell, and the many challenges they set for us. Some of these challenges included HIIT workouts done by professional athletes and other workouts demonstrated by our Year 10s. However, one of the most exciting challenges was the hair flip challenge. Many students across all year levels sent a video or photo with their creative hair flip. This was a fun way to stay connected, as all the photos and videos were put together and it was a good laugh. However, we did receive some heartbreaking news about the New Zealand trip that was planned for the September school holidays and subsequently was cancelled. This hit a lot of the older students and teachers pretty hard, but although we were upset, we had the support of one another and the glimmer of hope of going next year. With this hope, everyone managed to stay positive, which is what makes this academy so special.
Now, despite Corona taking away many things from us, thankfully our Super 7s carnivals weren't too affected and we still got to participate in multiple throughout the year. These are always such a fun day where we are not only able to showcase new skills we have learnt, but also strengthen the bonds between our team members. However, these days are definitely not all about fun, and CAV as a whole produces amazing results every time. One of our best performances was in Term 3 when we returned home winning every single division we participated in. We should all be so grateful that we are given opportunities to play in carnivals so often, especially with the amount of effort that goes into organising them. And whilst not all of them are here tonight, we'd just like to extend our thanks towards the teachers that take time off school to come down and help with the day, because it wouldn't be possible without you.
Over the year, early morning and after school sessions have been on offer to provide more assistance to improve our basic skills and get some specialist shooting training in. On top of this, though we have been fortunate to receive specialist coaching in areas from the best of the best, Vicky Wilson for our shooters, Katie Walker for our midcourts, and Claire McMinimum for our defence. These sessions provided everyone with a deeper insight of their position and also their knowledge of the game, and we soaked up every bit of advice. We also started this term looking at improving our own umpiring skills. With 5 umpiring workshops included in our program, you can already see the confidence building in these girls, not only with their whistle on court, but in their communication and leadership skills.
Now, if we want to demonstrate just how strong the Cav Road Netball Academy is, inter-school sport is definitely the way to go. This year was probably one of Cav's most successful years. We had the Year 7s absolutely killing every single one of their games and finally beating Wavell 32-17 in the grand final. This year, the Year 8s missed out on the Met Finals, going down to the eventual winners, St. Peter Claver, in the semi. This result is one you should be very proud of, because we certainly are, and we can't wait to see you take them on next year. As always, the Year 9s annihilated every one of their opponents, eventually beating Northside Christian College in a one-sided grand final, 62-12. This year, our Grade 10 team also had a lot of success in the Met Final series, as we won our grand final against Corinda State High, 43-33, for the second year in a row. However, inter-school sport does not just display Cav's strength on court. It also reveals our ability to work well in a team and how to remain humble. Even if we don't end up playing for the Firebirds when we leave the academy, we will take away these important qualities, which is what makes the Netball Academy just so special.
To end off Term 3, we had Leadership Day, which was split into 3 parts. The first half of the day involved working with an ex-Australian Army veteran who came in and helped shape our leadership skills. They taught us what it takes to be a good leader and also what it takes to work as a team. We then headed indoors for a chat with Rebecca Sparrow. She talked to us about school, friends, and everything in between. We learned what it meant to be happy with friends and also ourselves. Rebecca gave some very valuable knowledge to us all that I think we will all remember. The last and final session ended off with some dancing. We had Rachel Tiernan from Superstars come in and teach us how to work as a team while dancing. How important it is to take that leap and step outside our comfort zones and to just have fun. We learned an easy dance which everyone participated in, and all you could hear were giggles from every single person. At the end, there was a little dance competition, and although the teachers did not announce who won, we all know it was a great tense.
Where am I?
You distracted me, guys. Jeez. This was the perfect way to end the day on a positive note, and I know we were all very thankful to have such a great day.
At the end of the September school holidays, a selected team of junior and senior girls participated in the Vicky Wilson Cup tournament. Cav was extremely privileged to be selected to play in this carnival, as only the top schools from around the state were given this opportunity. For this reason, we knew that the competition was going to be very tough. In the weeks leading up to the comp, when we were yet to find out if Cav was chosen, the junior team continued to work hard, attend every training, and always put in 100% effort. This definitely paid off at the carnival, because they were a force to be reckoned with. They were probably in the toughest pool, and so it was a massive accomplishment to have 2 wins, 2 losses, one against the team that eventually won, and 2 draws, one of which being to their rivals, Moreton Bay. Our senior team also had a very tough pool, experienced mixed results, and whether we made it to the finals or not came down to the last game, where we only lost by 5. Overall, despite both teams not progressing to finals, it gave Cav the opportunity to test our skills against the best of the best And we certainly walked away knowing that we are right up there and deserve to be regarded as one of the best netball schools in Queensland. Watching our open boys team compete for the first time this year at Vicky Wilson was also very exciting, and we can see just how quickly this interest in boys netball will grow here at school. I know that next year all three teams will only come out better and stronger. Now, whilst this dinner may feel like the end of the year for the Netball Academy, it certainly isn't. We still have many more exciting things coming up in the next couple of weeks, one of which being the fitness testing and physio screening on November 12th. This will be a great opportunity to have a look at our current fitness level and what is required for our position on court, as well as identifying our risks of injuries so that next season we can all be fitter and injury free. Also coming up tomorrow night, actually, for a couple of Cav teams is a twilight tournament held at the Logan Netball Association. This should be an awesome event where and gives us a chance to verse different teams from around that area. Sadly, it will also be the last opportunity for all the year 10s to play together, and so we'll have to make the most of it.
Finally, we would just like to acknowledge all of the people that made this year and every year so memorable. Mrs. McCarthy, Mr. Thompson, Ms. Bairstow, and all the admin staff, thank you for your continued support of the Netball Academy and believing in the opportunities provided to us. Mrs. Mercer, even though we only had you as an inter-school coach, we only heard positive things from all the other grades about how awesome you are. We are also sad that you have to leave us, and we wish you could stay longer with us. Thank you for everything you did for the Academy this year. Mrs. Southwell, with COVID hitting at the end of Term 1, your time at CAB probably felt a lot shorter than what it really was, but we wanted to say thank you for the time and effort you put in, and we all loved your infectious enthusiasm. We hope your little new boy is behaving and looking after you.
To all our teachers that supported us through inter-school, sport and Super 7 tournaments, thank you for giving up your time to help us become better players. And finally, to Mrs. Stickney, we honestly do not have the words to express how grateful we are for you. You put so much effort and enthusiasm into every single training, carnival and lesson and inspire us to put in 110% effort all the time. The Academy would be absolutely lost without you. You have presented us with so many opportunities that have helped develop not only our skills, but our leadership, teamwork and communication. We are beyond grateful that we get to spend all of our lessons with you, and we thank you for making our last year so special.
To our Year 10 class, as our time is coming to an end, we just want to express how much you all mean to us and how much we loved our time in the Netball Academy. It gets said a lot, but we really are our own little family where everyone is valued. Getting to spend class with you for these last 4 years has been so amazing, and we are so sad that it has to come to an end. But we know that the bonds we have created will definitely last forever.
And lastly, some words of advice for the younger grades. Make the most of it. The expression, time flies when you're having fun, is very real. And the last 4 years for us have honestly gone by so quickly. We want to encourage you to make the most of your time in the Netball Academy because it doesn't last forever. You should take up every opportunity with effort and enthusiasm. Even if you don't feel like getting up extra early for training or staying after school, do it. Be grateful that we have so many opportunities to better our skills and take on board every single one of them. That's it. Thanks for listening to our speech, guys. Please sit back and enjoy a video highlight reel of the great year that we've had.
go to sleep when I got you next to me. I'm frozen in motion and my head tells me to stop. Tells me to stop. Feel things I feel about us. Try to fight it, but it's never enough. My heart is hurting, it's more than a crush. 'Cause I'm frozen in motion and my head tells me to stop. But my heart goes up, up, up. Oh my God, this feeling.
Tonight, there will be a chance for each of the year levels to come up and receive a certificate to congratulate them on their year in the academy. At the same time, a small number of special awards will be given out.
To get us started tonight, we would like to invite Mrs. Stickney, Mr. Thompson, and all of our Year 7 Netball Academy students to come up and join us here on stage.
If you can bunch in, because the camera won't get you from the step, so come in really close into the middle, and then they can come forward. Yeah.
You can see them all on the camera up there. You can see up there if they're.
Oh, okay. Cool. Awesome. Alrighty. Tonight we'd like to acknowledge the achievements of each of our academy classes. We will have three awards for each class. Firstly, there's a Players Player Award, which is voted for by the students. The girls vote for the player that they think always puts in 100% effort, is a hard worker, covers all of our key values of being in the academy, and is encouraging of their teammates. Secondly, there is a Most Improved Player Award, and there is a Player of the Year Award, which is selected by the coaches. Tonight we also want to acknowledge and celebrate the hard work and commitment that every single student has demonstrated throughout the year. So, Year 7, to our youngest family members, our Year 7 girls. We welcomed you at the start of the year as quiet, slightly nervous netballers, all excited at the opportunities ahead for the year. But it certainly didn't take long for you all to find your feet, settle in, and show us how passionate and enthusiastic you are. Despite the tricky circumstances surrounding COVID, you blew me away constantly with your resilience, your energy, and your enthusiasm. Before this year finishes up, I will overlay some video footage of you guys back in term one with how... No, not tonight. with how you are playing now. And I know you'll get a kick out of how much you've improved this year. You've become faster, more dynamic, and stronger. And this translates to a group of players now on court who are a lot more balanced, consistent, and accurate. This flowed over into your inter-school results, where you demonstrated how much depth and strength you have. Both the A and the B teams were unbeatable, and the A side continued all the way through to finally being crowned Metro champions, defeating Wavell State High in the final. But of course, your on-court play is only part of it. And I love seeing the joy netball brings to each of you, your excitement at being part of the Netball Academy at Cav, and the respect you have for each other. Thank you so much for a ton of fun this year. Continue to grab every opportunity presented with two hands and always look out for each other. Your desire to improve, coupled with your supportive and encouraging demeanour, means you are a teacher's dream, and I thank you for all your efforts this year. If you could each step forward as I call your name to accept your certificate. Jenna Balmer. Nina Brown. Saskia Bury. Mia Burke. Abby Carroll. Alice Conlon. Arabella Darlington. Kaya Dawson. Giselle Flynn Constantino. Oh, I'm sorry, I should have practiced. Charlotte Frangie. Frangie, oh, apologies. Mia Griffiths. Adelaide Hall. Joanne Harding. Phoebe Home. Abigail Kilner. Ella Crepan. Ambryn Lau. Ruby Laverty. Montana McConnell. Evie Nugent. Kate Peterson. Ayla Reeves. Jessica Searle. Evangeline Thomas. Alicia Vega. Or Vega, sorry. Ava Woolridge. Eva Young. And finally, Brooke Zander. Now to our special awards for this evening. Our first award tonight is our Most Improved Player. The winner of the Most Improved Year 7 Player literally could have actually gone to any one of the girls. As just mentioned, the netball this class is playing at the end of this year is in stark contrast to when they started. This award is going to a young lady that has listened and taken on board every piece of feedback and advice given to her. She arrives at every session keen to learn and with a positive attitude, and any extra sessions before or after school, you will find her there, working on her passing, pivoting, and her positional understanding. Because of her dedication and determination, she has improved her netball this year tenfold. Our big congratulations to Charlotte Frangie. Nice. Sorry, Charlotte. Our second award is our Players Player Award. This is always a very special award for each year level because the girls know what an honour it is to be recognised by your classmates. The Year 7 Players Player was recognised for the following reasons, and these were written by her classmates. She is an outstanding player who always works hard in a game and class situations, always giving her best. She is a team player and will play whatever role in the team that they need her, even if it means playing out of position. But on each nomination sheet for this player, they all refer to the encouragement that she provides her teammates, her positive attitude on court, and her kind and supportive nature. The Year 7's Player Player Award goes to Kaya Dawson. And finally, the Year 7 Player of the Year. This was a very tough decision, as this Year 7 group has strength in a lot of positions on court. They didn't lose a game all year, and I only wish I could give out multiple award winners. The player I have chosen has been an absolute strength in the defensive end from day one. She was one half of a formidable defensive duo in the circle who always kept their team in a game through many turnovers. Then in attack, she was Miss Reliable, always providing a strong option for us with her hands, footwork, and passing of a very high standard. Her ability to read the play coming down the court is one of her strengths, and she made life incredibly difficult for all those goal attacks she opposed. Our 2020 Year 7 Player of the Year goes to Jenna Baumer. Baumer.
Thank you, Year Sevens, and congratulations on your fantastic first year in the Academy. You may sit down now.
And you can do it.
I like this side better.
Oh, okay. And then we'll call up Maeve.
Literally, this is gonna take like 20 minutes. And then like, oh,
oh yeah, she's gonna take forever.
You probably can see like, who gets the awards on here.
Did it for them?
Oh,
well, I don't really care. It'll be Evie, 100%.
Yeah,
because I don't think she's looking at her.
We are now moving on to a very exciting part of our dinner, where we get to introduce our guest speaker for this evening, Joe Weston. I'd like to invite Maeve up to tell us a little bit more about Joe and all of her phenomenal achievements to date.
For those who don't know Joe very well, let me give you a quick run through of some of her amazing career highlights. Oh, I'm nervous, sorry. I'm so nervous.
So for those of you who don't know Jo very well, let me give you a quick rundown on behalf of Maeve. So Jo first debuted for the Melbourne Vixens back in 2014, and her rise to the top happened very quickly after that, as it was only at the end of her second year with the Vixens when she was selected to represent Australia. Jo is considered one of the best circle defenders in the world, and she has already ticked off a couple of her bucket list items. In 2018, she represented Australia at the Commonwealth Games, and in 2019, she was a member of the Australian Diamonds team that brought home a silver medal from the World Cup. This year, only a couple of weeks ago, Jo was an influencing factor in the Melbourne Vixens winning their first Suncourt Super Netball title. Away from the court, Jo loves to rollerblade, loves to travel and read, and is involved in charity work and environmental causes. I loved her best pieces of advice, which was always try and better your best, as this ties in so perfectly with what we have all been attempting to achieve this year. Please give a warm welcome up to the microphone, Australian Diamond, Jo Weston.
Thank you for the introduction, Maeve and others. Hi, I'm Jo. Thank you very much for having me. I was just talking to the Fabo teachers about how lovely it is to be, I think, in a school setting. This year's been so crazy and so different for all of us, but I think something that's probably been missing, even though I've been able to play netball this year, is the feeling it brings in terms of connecting with the community and especially young women like yourselves. So number one, you all look fabulous tonight. I'm definitely underdressed, but that's what happens when you pack one bag, when you think you're going for 4 weeks and you end up being away for 4 months and you have no room to take things back. So a little bit about me, I guess. I'm a defender, but I started playing in the midcourt when I was younger. So I grew up in Alpine, Victoria. I'm not sure if any of you are from regional Queensland, so where I'm from, it snows. It's either too cold or it's too hot. And we have a walnut farm. So I grew up just hanging around there, hanging with the sheep, hanging with my two older brothers. And the three of us were always pretty competitive, I think, as families go. Luckily, I have outachieved them in the sporting world since then. So that's my claim to fame. But yeah, so I have two older brothers, and in my extended family, I am one, I think there's 16 grandchildren, and I'm the only girl. So I have lots of male cousins, and I've got two older brothers. So when I moved to Melbourne and I started at a new school, something I think which I loved about netball to begin was being able to play with other females. I know men's netball's increasingly ever popular, but But for me, that's something that's been really special throughout my journey, playing both with the Vixens and with the Diamonds, and even the very first school team I played with. So I went to a school, moved to a school in Melbourne. It's called Sacre Coeur. It's similar to the Stuart home up here, I think, because I actually lived at Stuart home for a term in year 8, which is a sidetrack. But I played with a team we were called the Sack Shooters, and we were awful, which was a great introduction, I think, to the sport we all love. And after a few seasons, we got reclassified, and then we started winning. And I think once I got a taste from that, and I also grew 10 centimetres and got moved back into the defensive circle, I think that's where my real zest for netball kicked in, because I'd played other sports. I played tennis, which I still enjoy to this day, and I'd also danced. I've done ballet and jazz lessons, which I think is very good for your footwork. Great co-curricular extra training if you're looking into it. But for me, it was the team aspect, which I really loved. So, and I think just being competitive, and I think my parents would describe me as enthusiastic yet slightly annoying, because obviously I grew up annoying both my parents and my brothers, and many would say I probably bring out similar traits on the netball court. I don't know where Jackie is, but she could probably argue that one too, as a wing defence, goal defence kind of thing. But yeah, so I think I've been very lucky, obviously, as they indicated before, to have probably a pretty quick rise, I think, to the elite netball roads. But when I was playing at school, I didn't go to a sports specialist school like you guys did, which I just think is amazing. There's so many opportunities for you to get such a good foundation to build off. When I left school and I graduated and I moved to the AIS, which is the Australian Institute of Sport in Canberra, I arrived there probably 2 years behind a few of the girls who had come through pretty intensive programs in their last few years at school. So I didn't have a great passing technique, and some would argue when I'm passing down here, it's still not that fabulous. But for me, it was really about working on my basic skills and, you know, building a foundation from there alongside everything else. So I finished school. I was lucky enough to move to Canberra, which is probably not a saying that many people would have come out of their mouth. It was very cold, but for me, coming from Alpine Victoria, I was like, this is my temperament. Queensland, however, a bit hot for Joe, but we'll take what we can get. So after I moved to Canberra, the coach there was Julie Fitzgerald, and she now coaches the Giants. And I obviously have had some amazing coaches throughout my time, now under Simone McInnes at the Diamonds, at the Vixens. But Julie was probably instrumental to seeing some potential in me I probably didn't see in myself before. I was very tall, I was very lanky, and probably had a natural athletic ability. But when it came, you know, she really was able to bring the best out of myself and work with me to try and bring those attributes out on court. Fast forward, I moved from Canberra, and I've been lucky enough to be offered a position at the Melbourne Vixens. So I grew up watching a bit of netball. I was a Kestra's fan, as I was talking to Miss Stigney before. I loved Julie Corletto, who played goal defence, and she was the main reason I supported them, even though I don't think they were very successful back in those days, were they? No. But she was my favourite player, and I have many photos of me alongside her when she played for the Vixens. And then I think something which has probably been one of my special, like most special moments, is when I first walked into Diamonds camp, she was still in the wider squad. So for me, that was pretty surreal, because I'd grown up idolising her. And I just hope to this day she still doesn't just think I'm some super fan. But there wouldn't be anything wrong with that, to be honest. So I've played with the Vixens now since 2014. So quick math, this will be my 6th, 7th year. I'm not really sure how the contracts work, but the first year I was in the team, we actually won the premiership in ANZ. So really started with a bang. It wasn't all downhill from there, but it probably did dip off a little bit and then plateaued. And it's kind of been going like this, I think, on a domestic level for me. But with anything in sport, I think you get some really good lessons along the way. And one of those for me, especially in those first few years with Vixens, was about, I think I'm a pretty impatient person, and you know, when you join a team, sometimes you have to wait for your opportunity. And for me, that's what happened in my first few years of Vixen. So I was sitting alongside Bianca Chatfield and Jeeva Mentor, who's still playing now. And it was an amazing opportunity to learn. But for me, I just desperately wanted to be out on court and being able to, you know, show what I could do. And, you know, it takes time, I think, to build your whole game rather than just having one thing that you're really good at. And over that time period, although it was a little bit difficult to see a few of my friends, so both Liz Watson and Kate Maloney, the three of us were in the team that year. Both of them were out on court playing week in, week out. And up to that date, we'd all sort of been tracking along at the same wavelength. And, you know, it's really great, I think, when you get given something which might not be the most ideal situation, to take what you can from it and then kind of implement that at a later date. And I think that's something I try and pass on to everyone we chat to, that good things happen to everyone, but sometimes they just happen at different times. And in netball or in sport in general, I think being in the right place at the right time is sometimes how things go. So that would probably be right about how I managed to get a gig in the Diamonds selection-wise. So as I said before, I played in the World Cup last year, and that's a pinnacle event that happens every 4 years. So in 2015, there was a World Cup in Sydney. I'm not sure, maybe a few of you would have watched. Australia won. You probably were a little bit young, maybe. But after that, a whole lot of the defensive unit kind of all retired at once. And for me, I just happened to have been kind of right place, right time, right age, right position. And that's kind of how I managed to get a start in the Australian team. Obviously, I think I did a lot of work with my team to get myself in the position to be selected. But that's how sport goes. Sometimes it's all about timing, whether it's retirement or whether it might be injury to people. That's sometimes how opportunity comes up. And I think no matter what the circumstance it is, as the girls were saying before, you've just got to make the most of it, whether it's 5 minutes out on court while someone's getting their ankle restrapped, or whether it's, you know, being a part of a team which is really successful and you might not get an opportunity out on court. That training environment that you're in is so important to your development overall. And yeah, I think this year with the Vixens obviously has been absolutely crazy. I feel like that's an understatement. Let's go with unprecedented. I don't think that word has been said enough this year. So we won the premiership, which was very cool. This year, I don't really know how to, well, for us in Melbourne especially, I think, obviously I had to come up and quarantine in Queensland when the competition got moved up here, which, although people say it's kind of difficult, I enjoyed the experience because I like spending time with my teammates and we get on really well. But I think being away from home for such a prolonged period of time made us really, I think, value each other in a different way. It would kind of be before, you know, we were really friendly, we might have been more like co-workers, and now we really are a family because we didn't have the avenues of support we usually would when we're living back home in Melbourne. And yeah, we've been very lucky to Queensland to take us in this year. Obviously, I've been working on my tan heaps and, you know, visiting all the hotspots. I've been to Noosa, I've been to the Gold Coast, just all over Queensland. But alongside that, I feel like all of us have really learnt about what it means to be, I think, a part of the netball community when something's taken away from you, whether it's a sport you love or separation from family. It really, you know, makes you think about how lucky you were to have even a small part of that to begin with. And, you know, that's something we've all been really, really grateful for. So, yeah, thank you for having me. Looking forward. Obviously, I'm going to be playing with the Vixens next year. We might go back-to-back. We are looking for some shooters. If there's anyone in the house that wants to come on down, I heard you got an influx of shooters. We don't have any shooters because two of them retired. So there could be some opportunity down south if I can lure you down with the fabulous weather and great coffee. But, you know, I count myself very lucky to do what I do, and we get to meet some amazing people. Although, you know, sport teaches you lots of things, and it's such a cliche thing, I think, to stand up here and tell you about how I've learnt this from this and how I've learnt that from that. We all have really individual experiences when it comes to participating in sport or in life, and I think sharing those is what makes them really special. But Yeah, so thank you for having me. Thank you for supporting the Vixens and the Diamonds. I will give you a few other inside stories just to make this worth your while. So as I was watching the presentation before of your year in review, I noticed a few girls of you wearing foam visors, very sun safe. Fun fact, my mum used to make me wear a visor when I played rep netball down in Melbourne. You wouldn't have think the weather was worthwhile of a visor, but apparently it was. So I used to wear a red one, which matched my uniform, very colour coordinated. Fast forward 5 years, I'm playing in a Victorian state team and I'm at a trial and they're like, oh, I know you, you're visor girl. Like, we used to see you play all the time. Oh, Lord. And I was watching you dance just before, which I think, obviously, I'm an avid dancer. I'm trying to drag all my Vixens teammates onto TikTok, much to their dismay. But we do team building like you guys do. We do some really great development with people who might be ex-special forces or, you know, people who talk about personal development. We did a dance competition a few years ago and we all learned to coordinate a dance like you guys were doing. It was a little bit slightly more technical, which I was quite enthused about. Kate Maloney, who is our captain, you wouldn't know it, but she's quite shy. So we were doing it and she decided to stand deliberately behind me so she couldn't be seen by our extended group that was watching, but I don't think she realised that the seats were staggered, so it doesn't matter if you're standing directly behind someone, you can still see them the entire time, and every time we bring it up, I bring up the video, obviously, everything's documented these days, and yeah, so, you know, netball has given me so much, as I'm sure it's given all of you. When I played at the Commonwealth Games in 2018, that was surreal for me, because I actually danced in the 2006 opening ceremony in Melbourne. Not sure if you go, oh yeah, you probably would have been alive back then. I feel like I'm getting onto that vintage a little bit. But I got to be a part of the opening ceremony in Melbourne, which was a very cool experience, as in a big tutu, and we danced. And then fast forward 12 years later, I was actually an athlete walking out at the Commonwealth Games up on the Gold Coast. So it is really funny how things come full circle. So I think that's about it. You've got a few other awards to get to, so I'm not going to take up too much of your time. So thank you for having me. If you have any other questions, I'm sitting right there, so you can just come and give them to me. And that's it.
Thank you so much, Jo. On behalf of the Cav Road Netball Academy, we can't thank you enough for joining us here tonight and sharing so many wonderful stories and with us and for the valuable advice. We think you're amazing, you're an incredible role model to us all, and we wish you the very best of luck next year with the Vixens and the Australian Diamonds. Please accept these flowers as a token of your appreciation. Are they?
Thank you. I'm going to walk out this one.
We would now like to move on to our next awards this evening, and this is recognising the great work our Year 8 girls have been doing. Could all Year 8 girls please make your way up onto the stage, and could I ask Mrs. Southwell and Miss Russell to join them?
Oh, we won't look. I'll just move it forward.
Okay, so to the Year 8 girls. Oh, Rosie's not here yet, sorry. We'll wait for Rosie. Do we slow clap? Well, shall we slow clap her in? Here she is. Oh, Rosie, beautiful. She can join. Okay, to the Year 8 girls. What an incredible bunch of young ladies who have shown talent and determination both on and off the court. As a group, You've all worked together to improve your skills and overcome any challenges that 2020 have thrown your way. I hope you walk away from this year with confidence in your ability to achieve anything you put your minds to. Thank you, girls, for showing me exactly what it is to be a Cavrodian. I enjoyed every minute with you, and I wish you all the best for next year. So now I'd like to introduce these girls to you. I'm going to apologise in advance if I do pronounce anyone's name incorrectly. Let's say it's baby brain, but okay, here we go. The grade eights, Rebecca Anesty, Charlotte Bloom, Natasha Brook, Jasmine Bryant, Maya Errington, Rosie Griffiths. Yay, Rosie. Isabel Haas. Amelie Herville. Sophie Hozak. Lana Korn. Freya Modra, sorry Freya. Lena Nadell. Celeste Nell. Madison Olive. Trinity Oxenham. Claire Phillips. Dakota Pike. Rihanna Rihanna, my apologies. Layla Scott, Samantha Stunner, Alice Taylor, Lucy Taylor, Bryn Turner, and Isabel Walker. Can we put our hands together for these wonderful girls? All right, so to the three awards for this evening. The first one, most improved. The Year 8 Most Improved Player for 2020 has shown persistence, commitment, and an unwavering ability to never give up. Being left out of the team can be heartbreaking, but sometimes these occasions allow us to truly see what someone is made of. This young lady faced this situation this year where she could have been sulking, she could have given up and thrown in the towel when a team was named and she was left out. But credit to her, she continued to arrive to each class ready to learn, keen to hear what else she could do to improve. And she hasn't stopped working on all the aspects of her game. Her desire to be a better player has meant she's made the most of all the training sessions and is justly awarded tonight being our Year 8 Most Improved Player. Congratulations, Celeste Nell. Okay, award number two. The Year 8 Player's Player. There were so many beautiful things written about this player. What stands out immediately is the overwhelming feeling that she's very inclusive of everyone, caring and respectful. She's an outstanding player on court, she always gives 100% and never gives up, and it's these attributes that make other players around her push themselves to be better. Her teammates love her smile, enthusiasm and how hard working she is. She has clearly had a big impact on the classmates this year, and I can understand why they voted for her. So this year, can we please put our hands together? A big congratulations to Alice Taylor. Congratulations, guys. Okay, and Year 8 Player of the Year. This was another difficult decision because there were certainly a few girls putting their hands up for this award. This student has had a big year of netball, playing a big role in her inter-school team. She represented her association at state age, but it was the Vicky Wilson Cup final series this year that we saw how big of an impact she had on the court. She is willing to put in the hard work. I can hear all the whispers behind me. She's willing to put in the hard work that is required to be a defender, yet at the same time can keep her vision up and make her intercepts just when the team needs her the most. She's a big game player and has strength and guts, determination in bucket loads. Our Year 8 Player for the Year goes to Sophie Hozak. Congratulations, girls.
Thank you.
Did you introduce them? Yeah, I think I did. Is it this one? Oh, no. Oh, yeah. Do you want me to read?
Yep.
What the great part?
Yep.
When's dessert?
It is.
Okay, tell us. Okay.
Oh, wait, no.
No, don't look.
Oh, is it?
I think that's your nines. Okay.
Oh, it is a great nines. Well.
Oh, well.
That's fine.
Just speak. Thank you, Year 8, and congratulations again. We are going to move straight on to our Year 9 awards, and we'd like to invite the Year 9s up to the stage with Miss Southwell and Miss Mercer.
Oh, I'm too short. All right. I stand on my toes. I don't know where I'm up to. There we go. Okay. Stand forward. Stop being all so afraid. Oh. All right. I guess firstly I'd like to start by saying thank you to Miss Russell for going and playing for Lightning, so I got the opportunity to come and work with you guys, even if it was just for a really short time. You're certainly outrageous and loud and in your face, but in a good way most of the time. So, you know, you are truly an amazing bunch of individuals who have certainly had some ups and downs this year. However, your perseverance to continually push forward and improve both on and off the court has been a privilege to watch, and I am thankful to have had the opportunity to be your teacher. We worked on leadership, and I saw you work together as teams. We worked on strategies and set plays, and I saw you be creative and collaborative. Lastly, we worked on fitness, and I saw your determination and commitment to improve. These are all admirable qualities and skills for life, not just for netball. So make sure you are also finding the time to enjoy the game. I guess straight into it. There's a change on my sheet here. Oh, yeah. Thought I was going to get to practice my speech before I spoke. Okay, so going to call you up and say thank you for your year that has been. So first up, Emma Anderson. Priya Clonan, Zara Connery, Kaya Henderson, Bella Ibrahim, Destiny Knight. Becca Lan. Georgette Martin. Grace Mina. Eden Moratti. Poppy Priestley. Prue Raftery. Jess Reed. Bridie Routh. Imogen Smith. Sophie Strongman. Sophia Thompson. Mae Vandenberg. Scarlett White. Ella Woolridge. Amber Yates. And Claudia Zivic.
Oh, and you all moved back again. Move forward. Ah, it's not that scary. Yeah. Okay, so now to our awards for the most improved this year. This player shows tremendous dedication to refining her performance in the Netball Academy and deserves to be recognised for the improvement she has made this year. She's been committed to the additional trainings offered and is always seeking feedback on how to improve her performance. You are commended for your perseverance and hard work, Sophia Thompson. Player's player. This player received an overwhelming number of votes from her peers who have said the following about her. And I've collated them together because a lot said the similar things. This person displays many of the qualities that a player's player should, and she is always enthusiastic, kind, and leads by example. Some of the words used to describe her ability were incredible, talented, and amazing. However, this is a credit to the hard work and effort she puts into every lesson, both on and off the court, as well as her determination and commitment to continuously improve. She is described as a great team player who is considerate of the ideas, abilities, and beliefs of others. This is demonstrated through her integrity, reliability, and respectful attitude towards players, umpires, and coaches. Lastly, something we should all aim to emulate in the academy, and a comment that really stood out to me. When I am on her team, I always feel supported, heard, respected, and included. Thank you for being the 2020 Player of the Year, Imogen Smith. All right, what have we got left? Okay, Player of the Year. Always a difficult decision, and honestly, it could have gone to a number of worthy contenders. However, the 2020 Player of the Year was selected for her versatility, determination, and ability to make an impact during a game. Not only has she been an excellent player, but also a reliable and enthusiastic member of the Netball Academy. I'll miss seeing her Laura Geitz-like intercepts in an effort to turn possession from the back line. Congratulations, Poppy Priestley. Yeah.
Get downstairs. Yeah. I
Okay. Everyone, it is time for dessert, and the gourmet churros look incredible. We're going to take a break for 20 minutes whilst everyone enjoys themselves, and when we come back, we'll be straight into the Year 10 Awards.
I don't think it was on.
Yeah. Bye. Yeah, please leave.
Chuck the deuce up.